Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, let us go through A254 guys. So the Intel A254 is a programmable interval timer slash control counter, which is a functional similar to the software designed counter and timer. So what does a counter or timer do guys? It counts the things that we do. Our timer is something like a countdown. So it also includes three identical 16-bit counters, and it is a 24-pin DIP package requiring a 5 volts power supply. So it is almost similar to 8253 guys. Yeah, that's what it's written here. It is an upgraded version of 8253, where the 8254 can operate with higher clock frequency, ranges from DC to 10 megahertz, where that range is still 2.6 megahertz only. So read back command is possible in 8254 guys. So it can read in both the directions. So that's the major advantage of 8254. And now let us go through what are the features of 8254. So it has three independent 16-bit down counters. It can operate in a frequency of DC to 10 megahertz. Three counters can be programmed either with BCD or binary. So it can be programmed again in six different modes, compatible with all the microprocessors. It has a read back command. It has a powerful read back command. So the pin diagram is absolutely similar to that guys, almost. But there will be only a small change I found guys. Okay, there is no change guys. I forgot this. In this there is no change. So first we will be writing ground, power supply, the 8 data lines. Then we will be writing for channel 1 or counter 1, sorry, clock output gate. Here also we got clock output gate guys. That's the only difference. There these two shuffled, right? Or this is the correct order. Okay, just check that guys before you are reading this. So clock output gate, clock output gate, clock output gate. In this, the three are similar in order. Here we'll be having address line A0 and A1, chip select, read, write. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on this diagram. So now let us go through this. Is this clear or shall I bring my book guys? It's all up to you. It's not clear guys. I'll be bringing my book. Just give me a second. Okay, hello guys. Let us continue. So this is almost similar to 8253 guys. So we'll be having the counter 0, counter 1, counter 2, clock gate out, clock gate out, clock gate out. So these three are connected to an internal bus, where the internal bus is connected to data bus, that is nothing but D0 to D7. And it is connected to control board, and this is connected to read-write logic that will be connected to control board, where the operations like read-write addresses will be transferred into it. If CS is active, low, only then we'll be having the access for it. Only then we can do the multiple operations. So that is the block diagram of 8254, which is 100% similar to 8253 guys. So be perfect with 8253, you can draw 8254 also. So I'll be just giving you an overview guys, because we already learned all these things in the previous tutorial itself. So D7 to D0 are nothing but 8-bit data. Clock 0 means indicates clock with respect to their counters. Output 0, 1, 2 indicates the output with respect to their things. Gate 0, 1, 2, 3 indicates their gates. G and D is nothing but ground. VCC is plus 5 volts power supply. WR is nothing but for write. RD bar is for read. CS is nothing but chip select. A0 and A1 are the addresses to select the counter. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this guys. So now, so in the next tutorial we will be going through the differences between 8253 and 8254. Thank you. Thanks for watching.